Hello all. In this session, we'll try to understand banking system. But before that, let us have a look at this picture. So, what is this? So, here you are able to see a overhead tank, and you are also able to see a small tank attached to that, and a tank here means from the overhead tank we are getting the water here. And next, here we are able to see a pump. Okay, here we are able to see a pump. So whenever the water in this tank exceeds, so it will be pumping the water back to the main tank. And suppose this tank water is empty, means less. So then we will turn on this overhead tank. So means attached tank, small emergency tank we can say. So we are getting water from here. Pump is sucking the water back into the main tank. If the main tank water is not available, immediately we can on this emergency tank. And in this picture we are also able to see the water from the broader source, like it may be river or sea. So from here also water is entering into this tank. Okay, so assume that in this tank, suppose water is exceeding, means overflowing. Okay, suddenly what we will do? So we will switch on this pump so that it will reduce the water from this system. Correct? And it may be water may be from this side, that is from the overhead tank, or maybe from the outside. Welcome to the banking chapter. So it is very often we hear that the market, the word liquidity, the word repo, the word reverse repo. Fine. So when a consumer like me or you want money from bank, means money for our purposes, so where we go? We go to bank. Correct? As a common man, so I go to bank. So for me, okay, this bank will lend the money. But from where the bank will get money from? So bank will get money from RBI. Correct? So banks will get money from RBI and we get money from banks. Means it is symbolically I am showing one bank, there are multiple banks. Okay, so we want money. So here the money concept is usually measured through liquidity. Like water, the money flow is like water. So in this session, we will try to understand these technical concepts using this model. Okay. So we want money means obviously the bank should have money. Banks will borrow money from the RBI. Correct? Banks will borrow from RBI. Suppose you are like you want a home loan, you will apply to the bank. Correct? So they will assume that just you are, they are giving 100 rupees. Okay. So for that, how much interest you are paying annually? That is around like 7%. Right? 7%. So if they want to give it to you 7%, they must be getting you at a lower rate. Correct? So we are, because they also work for profit, right? So they are giving you at 7% interest rate. That is, if you are borrowing 100 rupees, you need to pay 7 rupees to them after the end of the year or on the monthly basis, whatever. Fine. So banks want money from RBI. Correct? So they will borrow. How they will borrow? Because it is not like, see, Suppose you want to build a big house. If you ask 1 crore, will the bank provide it to you? It depends upon like how much salary you are, how much property you have, everything, right? So all customers will not get the same amount of loan from the bank. That depends upon his value, net worth, or credibility, whatever you say. Whenever your friend asks 10 rupees, easily will give. If he asks 1 lakh, you may give 10 lakh, 1 crore. So it differs. His worthiness to pay it back matters. Correct? So like that, individual will get the loan according to his capacity. In the same way, banks like bank 1 or it may be bank 2. Correct? So it is not like that same. The RBI will give whatever the amount they ask. So they also need some security. Correct? So these banks will pledge or give their securities. They give their securities to the banks. So based upon that, they will give money. Fine. That concept we will understand separately. Here we are trying to understand. So, okay, the banks are receiving money from the RBI. On what ground? Yes, depending upon the securities they have. Okay, so there, for example, I want to loan means I will pledge my property, I will give my property documents. So, based on that, he will give loan, right? The same way, they will give securities to RBI and they will get a loan. Okay, so in this scenario, we'll take this as the RBI and this as the broader market. Here the banks are there. So banks are taking money from the RBI. What is this? So this is controlling how much money is flowing here. Okay, how much money is flowing there? If it is tap is means that valve is controlled, so less amount of water will come here. If it is loosened, then more amount of water will come. What is the meaning of that? That is, if the banks give at a lower rate of interest, just at 3%, I will borrow more money, correct? If they say that 10%, okay, give me smaller amount of money. Same way, here, from this tap, okay, like, this is like the interest rate. We call that as repo rate. Repo rate. What do you mean by repo rate? It is the interest rate charged by RBI to the banks. Okay. So it is paying that much interest and borrowing money from RBI. Not only bank, so many institutions are there. It is symbolically, I am showing one bank. Correct? Sir, why this name repo? Why repo rate? Why it is called repo? Repo means repurchase. Repurchase. Who is telling that now banks are giving documents, that securities to RBI? Please give us loan. Correct? With the agreement that I will make sure that I will repurchase them back. Means I will get them back. That is why the name repo rate. You are giving securities to them so that they can give loan amount to you, but with the agreement that I will repurchase them back. Okay? Repurchase. So that you can give money. So if repo rate is high, repo rate is, for example, simply assume that 6%. Okay, so if repo is 5%, if repo is 4%, when you will borrow more money? The banks will borrow more money when it is at 4%. That is so much liberal. Liquidity is there, more of water here. Okay. So here, more of water. When it is 4%, that is more money will enter into the market. More money will enter into the market. Correct? Suppose it is at 6%. If it is like 6%. Okay? So, water will be less because banks will borrow less because it is costly money, costly loan. So, it will be less. 5%, it may be somewhat more. Means not completely full. But whatever, the repo rate ensures that money flows from RBI to banks. RBI to banks at certain rate of interest. It is called as repo because of the reason that we are assuring their agreement, making agreement and saying that we will repurchase it back. Okay. So, we understood higher the repo rate, so lower the money flow to the market. See, money flow is like a water concept, liquidity. So, we have taken this analogy because the liquidity is increasing here. Fine. So, depends upon the repo rate. Okay. Now, the question is, why RBI will sometimes give at 6%, sometimes give at 5%, sometimes give at 4%? That is based upon the situation. Based upon the situation. In the market, recession is there. That is during COVID time, people don't have money. Assume that scenario. So in such scenario, okay, business are not growing. So they want to give more money to the market so that business starts growing again. In such scenario, it starts giving at a lowest interest rate. Lowest interest rate, so that money in the market should increase. Okay, if it feels like, okay, already too much liquidity is there. Too much liquidity is there. Too much money is there in the market. So, then it will try to increase 6%. So, that banks will feel like, no Baba, we will not take it. Because consumer is also asking at 6%. If I take at 6%, what is left for me? What is left for me? That's why. So, like that, the complete water flow here, like money flow, will stop to the market. Right. Now, assume that the scenario, this is overflowing. Means too much water, too much water, too much water. So, too much liquidity. So, we are drowning in that liquidity, heavy liquidity. Sir, what is the problem? Let it overflow. Too much market. So, in the another session, we have understood what is inflation. Inflation is, just for the sake of completing this discussion, that is the persistent rise in the prices of the goods and services. Okay. When the available good is same, like only one penny is available, but everybody is having this much money. Too much money. So, I will inflate this price. What is the cost is 100 rupees. Now, I'll tell 500 rupees, 600 rupees, 700 rupees. Because everybody is having money. So, inflation is not good for the economy. So, for the discussion sake, forget about inflation. Too much money is there in this tank. What to do now? Yes, easy way. We have a pump here. Once this pump is switched on, the water from this tank, okay, will be pumped back to the main tank. Now, slowly, water again, market liquidity comes under control. No, so now there is not too much money. So now it is under control. This pump is sucking back money to the RBI. Interesting, right? So, what is this pump? This pump is known as, this pump, we call it as reverse repo. What is the meaning of that? Now, RBI will attract these banks, okay, so that they will keep money in the RBI. How they will attract? Okay, see, in the market, if they give loan to other people, so the banks will fear, that is, they may default. But RBI will never default. So they will do like, okay, earlier giving 4%. Now we'll give 5% interest rate. So here reverse scenario. That is RBI is borrowing from the banks. Why RBI is borrowing from the banks? RBI want to control liquidity here in the market. Too much money means inflation. That is not good for the economy. So they will lure the banks. We will only give more interest rate. Come, keep it with us. So now this pump is on. That is nothing but reverse repo. Exactly opposite of this. Here money is coming. Here money is going back to RBI. See how the market is maintained. How the liquidity in the market is maintained. Interesting, right? This is called as a reverse repo. So in the repo, banks are borrowing from RBI. In the reverse repo, so RBI is borrowing from the banks so that we can control the liquidity. Fine. Now, sometimes questions will be like, okay, why we need two tools to control liquidity in the market, repo and reverse repo? That is, repo is required. See, it cannot suck out the already existing water here, liquidity in the market. Only it can stop. But here, it can control the liquidity in the market. Fine. So, this much of water is removed because of this. Interesting, right? So, here, repo is like a vaccine. It can stop. This reverse repo is like a medicine. See, it can stop the water flow. That is, it can stop that over liquidity may happen. Stop. Prevention. This is curative, like medicine. Already over liquidity is there in the market. That is not good for the economy. So here, if over liquidity is there, the people are drowning in this. They are losing their life. So that should not happen immediately. It starts sucking water. It is like a medicine. So it is preventative. This is curative. This is like vaccine. This is like medicine. So now market is under control. No problem. Fine. So this is how the repo and reverse repo works. We need both because the function of this is prevention. This is curative, like giving solution to that problem. So that is very interesting. Now, another scenario we'll see. See, what is this river or ocean? See, this is like foreign market. So this is about India. Controlling within India. Okay. But this is like foreign funds. So these are like other like USA, Britain, Japan, whatever. All money from whole world entering into India. See. So it is entering into India. So it is again a challenge to RBI. But like this. So, it is stopped. But even then, outside money is coming. Now, also the same thing. Reverse repo will work out. We call this as a open market operations. Like buying and selling of the security. Simple thing. When it buys, liquidity is controlled. When it sells, okay, liquidity is increased. Anyway, so here, the outside money, like through... So, we can say like foreign direct investment, foreign institutional investment. So, that money is also entering our market. Now, also RBI has to handle the same thing. So, whenever this external money is coming and we are handling, that scenario is known as sterilization. So, outside shock is controlled by RBI. Anyway. Fine. So, this is like outside money entering. This is within the system money is entering. How about, okay, this at least we have an idea how much money is coming, how much water can be taken away. We have that account. How about something which is coming to this market, but we don't have idea at all. That is nothing but the black money. That is very problem. because we know that 100 liters is there in the system, the pump will be on, switch on, so that 100 liters money will be sucked out. But we don't know how much black money is entering into the market. That is the biggest problem. So how RBI can take decision? Because we don't have accountability. Means we don't have measurement how much actually black money is entering the market. So that is disturbing. Anyway, that we'll discuss in a separate session. But understand, the liquidity can increase official channel RBI through outside source FDI, through corruption money. But whatever, the RBI is having a tool to control it. Sir, what is this separate tank? Emergency tank. So here, we said that banks are borrowing money. Banks are borrowing money from the RBI. Sometimes what happens, these banks are like about to collapse. For that, like how for our life we take emergency like insurance, so that during our crisis time it will help. Similarly, the banks will keep some small amount with the RBI. Suppose a customer deposits 100 rupees, out of that 4 rupees or 3 rupees, correct, is stored, given to RBI. So that in the case of crisis, RBI should help them. So that concept is known as CRR. This tank is known as CRR, cash reserve ratio. So they are giving as a reserve, cash reserve. Ratio means out of 100 rupees, 4 rupees is given, that is 4%. So that much is given. So during emergency, so RBI will give money from this small tank to the banks to save them. Okay. Anyway, that concept we'll explain it in a separate manner. But at least understand that. So banks are having, means RBI is helping them in the normal scenario through repo, so that money will be available with the banks. But during emergency, cash reserve ratio, when it is about to collapse, so RBI will come to rescue. Okay, anyway, this is like RBI, for reverse repo, RBI will give some interest rate. But for CRR, RBI will not give interest rate because that is the fund to save during emergency. Okay, so we have understood repo, reverse repo, CRR, cash reserve ratio, and sterilization when the outside money is coming. We don't have answer for this corruption because it is not that easy to handle it. Okay, and the banks are taking the help of CRR and also SLR, that we will take understand in a separate session. But here SLR is like banks are having some reserve money with them so that they can use during emergency. I hope you have enjoyed this, how the banking system works, how the loan system works, what is repo, what is reverse repo, what is sterilization, what is the role of RBI, how actually the reverse repo helps the helps in the reduction of the liquidity in the market, thereby it also helps inflation. So in order to check inflation, reverse repo is the solution. So repo cannot do anything, only it can stop. It cannot take away the existing extra money from the market. Extra market means more burden on the economy. It leads to inflation. Okay. So with this kind of models, we'll understand other economic concepts. There are many concepts, not only banking. In the next session, we will deal all those things. Thank you.